This video covers the INFACore installation process. Check out the other videos in this series by clicking the links on screen now, or find them in the description. Let's cover the prerequisites. JupyterLab must be version 3.4.2 or later. Also, you'll need a specific Python version. So make sure that your Python version is between 3.7.1 and 3.10.4. You'll need to download two things from the Informatica Marketplace, the INFACore Python SDK libraries and the JupyterLab extension. Find a link to the Informatica Marketplace in the description. Once you've downloaded them to the computer running your development environment, you're ready to go. Next, let's switch to our development environment to install the files. Today, I'm using Anaconda to add the Python SDK and JupyterLab extension packages. First, as a best practice, I'll create a new environment and activate it. Now we can install our downloaded packages, but we have to install them in the right order. So make sure that you install the Python SDK package called Informatica INFACore first. After, you can install the JupyterLab extension, named JupyterLab INFACore. Now we need to activate the extension we just installed. Great, with everything installed, let's switch over to Anaconda Navigator. From the environment we just created, let's launch JupyterLab Notebook. Notice in the extension manager, there's the JupyterLab INFACore package we just installed. And on the right, there's our INFACore icon. We can click the icon to launch the INFACore user interface. But before we log on to our INFACore account, we need to set up our organization URL. Let's go to the Settings tab, and then find INFACore. Now, for test environment URL, enter the organization URL you received by email when you signed up for INFACore. With that done, let's log in. Let's get familiar with the interface. It's broken down into three main sections. The runtime environment section is at the top. In the middle section, you can select your data source from many different options. And finally, at the bottom, you can apply functions to your data. Also, from the top ribbon, you'll notice icons where you can check out the activity and where you can download the logs. The last thing we need to do is install the local runtime environment. The runtime environment is the execution platform that runs all your INFACore jobs. Under Runtime Environment, click Install. The Informatica Cloud Secure Agent appears. We've already registered, so we can skip this. Once the installation completes, the status will update in the INFACore extension. If you need to, you can stop or restart the secure agent using the Cloud Secure Agent interface. And that's it. You now know how to install INFACore on JupyterLab. In the next video, we'll discuss how to connect to a data source. For more information, see the INFACore documentation on the Informatica documentation portal, visit our communities and support hubs, or check out our website.